It is now streaming live on Facebook, and we are now recording, I think. Yeah. Yep, it's recording. And somebody's in the chat. Who's in the chat? Landis, hey. That was Landis, say, hey. I'm online. I'm recording. I'll be out in a minute. Just hold on. I'm recording. I'll tell you in a minute. All right, we got four in the meetings. I'm gonna let everybody in before I turn it over to you.
Okay,
Brother C Alpha.
Good morning.
Good morning, everyone. To Maya. All right. Alpha, can I hear you? And now he connected. And I'm not even going to let you put down the screen here. I'm going to leave the screen up here. I'm going to just make you the host.
Okay.
All right. So you do welcome. You want to do the welcome and everything.
Okay. You said I want to do the welcome and everything.
Yes, because I'm not going to take down the screen.
Okay.
So this way we don't have no problem with the screen.
Okay, I got you. Yeah, yes.
So I'm getting ready to make you the host, and you can get started. It's 1 minute after 10.
Okie dokie.
All right. Let's see. Making you the host.
Okay.
Here you go.
All right. Good morning, everyone.
I don't like this. It's just the tablet.
No, that.
Good morning.
Let's see, hey, good morning, everybody.
Good morning. Good morning.
Hi. Peace and blessing.
Same to you. I'm not going to mess with that. I'm going to leave it right where it's at. Good morning. So we may want to start and have prayer here. Excuse me.
What are you doing?
Good morning. Father God, we thank you this morning for bringing us together, Father. Thank you. We can't thank you enough. We worship you and we praise your holy name. Glory and honor to your name. Thank you for each one that's here this morning. And we pray that your Holy Spirit teaches this lesson. Help each one to be able to grasp whatever is being taught and be able to live and run with whatever they hear, whatever the word of God says and speaks to their heart. Because this morning, Father, we will be discussing vision. And I pray that everyone has a vision and everyone just follow exactly the way Jesus, just following Jesus' footsteps. All things I ask in Jesus' name I pray, amen. And amen. Okay, for this morning, again, we will be discussing the process of vision. And I know that most of us have vision or had vision or need to have vision. It's important for our lives. Okay, let me see if I can move everybody around the bottom or... maybe, yeah, that's probably a little bit better, okay? So the word of God instructs us to write the vision and make it plain. Habakkuk, writing the vision is obedience to what God is calling us to do. The simple act of doing what the word of God tells us to do shifts us from being passive and inactive or laid back hearers to active and engaged hearers. Okay? So we have to not just be hearers of the word of God, but we have to be doers. We have to do what the words say. We can't just hear it and just lay back and not act on it. you know, or be passive, just hear it and just don't do anything, you know, just sitting and not going forth, because he said, go ye, okay? So we have to do, we have to engage, we have to move and do what the word tells us to do. So that's being active, an active hearer and an engaged or a person that's going to go and do what we learn, okay? And what the word is telling us to do, what the Father is telling us to do. The prophet Habakkuk lived through a period of spiritual decline. He lived through a period where people just had then fell away and just wasn't following the word of God. They just wasn't doing what they were supposed to do. They was doing everything except following what God told them to do, or just God's rule and his way. Among the people, he witnessed a lot of evil and wickedness. The people worshiped idols and were lovers of themselves. They was full of pride. They was just running amok. They was just doing whatever they wanted. Okay. Habakkuk cried out to God, but did not receive an answer when he wanted it. So he was losing faith and he was getting frustrated and didn't know what to do. And he was a little upset, I believe, with God. So Habakkuk was trying to grow from mental doubt and confusion to absolute trust in God. This is what he was trying to do. The Lord answered Habakkuk in chapter 2, verse 2 of the book of Habakkuk. He said, write the vision and make it plain on tablets, that he who reads it may run that readeth it. So I'm going to go to Habakkuk 2, and I'm going to read, okay? I'm trying to see if I want to start from 1. I'm going to read from 1 to 3, okay? Habakkuk, however you want to pronounce it. I will stand upon my watch and set me upon the tower and will watch to see what he will say unto me and what I shall answer when I'm reproved. And the Lord answered me and said, write the vision and make it plain upon tablets, that he may run that readeth it. For the vision is yet for an appointed time, but at the end it shall speak and not lie. Though it tarry, wait for it, because it will surely come. It will not tarry. Okay, so this is what God had told Habakkuk about writing the vision. Okay, he said, write the vision and make it plain. Okay, and those people that read it or those that want to follow the word of God and do the right thing, okay, they're going to run, they're going to pick it up and they're going to run with it like a baton. Okay, now I got this in my way. It says, write the vision. Until I embrace vision, life can be complicated. So I have to have some kind of vision, or else I'm just walking around like I'm blind and I'm bumping into things. I don't know where I'm going. I don't know what I'm doing. I need a vision. When your vision speaks, it helps you set boundaries. Okay, this is when vision speaks to you. You can set boundaries. And that's Proverbs 29 and 18. If you would go with me there, the 29 and 18. It reads, I'm going to see if I want to read it from the Amplified. I'm going to read it from the Amplified Bible. It says, where there is no vision, no redemptive revelation of God, the people perish. But he who keeps the law of God, which includes that of man, blessed, happy, fortunate, and inviolable is he. So if we keep the law of God and revelation of God, you are blessed, okay? I mean, it says it right here. You'll be happy and you'll be fortunate when you keep and do God's word. Where there's no vision, the people perish. We should live God's word, his wisdom, and his instruction for our lives. Excuse me. Let me move this back up. Oh, come on. Okay. You will never be successful in your vision until you truly understand vision. Okay. And the definition of vision, to be able to think about or plan the future with imagination or wisdom. I'm going to repeat that. Vision, a definition of vision, the ability to think about or plan the future with imagination or wisdom. Okay. So one way to know if your vision comes from God is to pass it through the filter of the Word of God. And that's the Bible. Okay. See if your vision has the same purpose as those found in the Word. So when we have a vision, when we have a dream, we have to go into the Word and make sure that it lines up with the Word of God and God's purpose and plan for our life. This is what we have to do. This is important, to go through the filter, go through the Bible first. Okay. Do anybody have any questions so far? Okay. Okay, Jesus had vision. Jesus' vision for man. Okay. I said Jesus' vision was to bring God's kingdom on earth. Okay. So that was Jesus' vision, to bring God's kingdom right here on earth for you and I. Jesus' vision was to reconcile man back to God. Okay, to bring us back to the Father after Adam and Eve sinned against God and lost dominion, okay? And we lost relationship with God because of sin. So Jesus' vision was to reconcile us back to the Father, okay? Jesus' vision was to take on the sins of man, to bring us back into right standing with God. So when Jesus went to the cross, okay, he went to the cross and died for our sins. Okay, he did this for us so that we could be back in right standing and right relationship with God. Because without Jesus going to the cross, we would just have perished. So this is what Jesus, this was his vision, so that on the other side of the cross was us, so that we would be brought into the family of God and have that relationship that God wanted for us from the beginning. Excuse me. Jesus' vision was for all men to repent, change their thinking and ways, and be transformed by the renewing of their mind. Okay? So this is what all men are to do. This is what Jesus' vision is, for us to repent, be quick to repent, live in a repentive state each and every day. Okay? So that when you do anything that's out of order or not in order with the word of God or the kingdom of God, then you could repent and you could get back on board. You could repent and then you ask the Father for forgiveness and you turn from those ways, okay? And start renewing your mind and your thinking that you're gonna live according to the word of God and do what God tells us to do, okay? Jesus' vision was to be a role model for us, to live the life God intended for us. And this is what Jesus did as he came and he walked here on earth. He was a role model for us to show us just how to live, how to handle issues and circumstances, to live the God kind of life. And he showed us that it could be done as men, as women, as children. It could be done. And he showed us this, that he set the example before us. Faith for vision. Sight is the function of the eyes, while vision is the function of the heart. When we say sight is the function of the eyes, this sight means you're looking, with you using your eyes to see. And whatever you see is just the sight is the function of the eyes, which you see with your eyes. But vision, okay, vision is the function of the heart. And I'll let you know what vision means again. Vision is the ability to think about or plan the future with imagination or wisdom. Okay. So that's what vision is. It comes from your heart. It starts in your heart. Okay. And then you can plan from there. And like I said, you should go through the Bible to whatever your vision is, or your dreams, to make sure that it lines up with the word of God. That's important. It's very important to always line up your visions and your dreams with God's word, to make sure that you are going in the right direction, okay? Sight is the ability to see things as they are. So when you look at something, you see it as it is. If it's red, if it's round, this is what you see with your natural eyes. While vision is the ability to see things as they could be or should be. So a vision is you can see something and you can say, you know what? That could be changed for the better, okay? It don't have to be like that. Maybe it should be this way or it could be this way, but we want it to be the right way that lines up with God's word, with each and everything that we say and we do in our life. God is supposed to be in it. That's how we win. We should never let what our eyes see determine what our hearts believe. Because sometimes our eyes see things, but it's not really the truth. It's not a true thing. It's what your eyes see. What you see with your eyes don't necessarily mean that that's I'm trying to see how I could explain this. Sometimes you may see something that's not really true. It's just, how can I do this? So you can understand it better. I'm trying to give an example.
Like a mirage.
Say that again.
Like a mirage.
You said a Milan?
Mirage.
Oh, okay. like a mirage. Mm-hmm. Okay. Yeah, that sounds good. Like a mirage.
Or maybe like when you're walking past somebody you know and they have this sad look on their face and it looks like they're sad, but that's just their face.
Right. Or even they look sad, but they might be in deep thought. And yeah. It may not be sadness. And they just might have something really deep that they're thinking about or serious. Yep. You know, and that's true. That is that right there is a good example, because you might say, oh, that person is just mean, but they might not be mean. They just might have a serious look on their face, but that's what your eyes saw or thought it saw, mm-hmm. but that don't necessarily mean it's true.
That's the natural eye, not the spiritual eye. The spiritual eye discerns what's going on in the spirit realm.
Right.
Sometimes spirit will tell you what's going on with the person.
And that's true. This is true.
You gotta be in tune. But when I say mirage, you remember how in the summertime and you look in the street, it looked like it's water?
Oh, you said like the heat wave?
Like a heat wave, and you see it looked like it's water, but it's mm-hmm. really a heat wave. Right. So you think you're seeing something, but it's not until you walk up on it.
Right. It's not what you actually see with your natural eyes.
Right.
Right. That's what I was trying to say, what I was saying. Yeah, so basically what you said, we should never let what we see with our eyes determine what we believe in our hearts. Mm-hmm. You know, and we just gave examples. Even like when we was talking about a person that, you know, how they look, going by how a person look and mm-hmm. thinking that that's exactly what it is, because that don't have to be how the person really is. If we say they frowning, or they mad, they angry, they mean, and they could just really have something on their mind, and it's just how their face look. The facial expressions, it just be how they look.
Right.
Okay.
Oh, I here's another example. When I was delivering mail, I used to walk past people and talk to them and say, hey, good morning, hello, something.
Right.
Like that. And they wouldn't speak. I said, I'm thinking negative, like, what is wrong?
Right.
Nobody's speaking, even grown folks, right? Come right. to find out, as I kept going, I said, oh, they don't speak English.
Oh, wow. They don't speak English, or they may not even be able to hear with their
right.
ears.
Right.
Maybe deaf.
Right.
Right. And that is true, because I've experienced that too, where you may have spoken to someone and they didn't say anything back, and you get that, your first response is, wow.
Right.
It was rude. They couldn't speak, but like you said, they may not speak our language.
Right.
Or they may not be able to hear, physically hear you.
Right.
You know, some people have hearing impairment.
Right.
Or hearing problems. Okay. So the vision in your heart is greater than your environment. So when we say the vision in your heart is greater than your environment, you could dream big. You could dream that you're going to be an astronaut, or you want to be a doctor or something like that, but your environment and all you hear, like, is people saying, you may be too poor, or you coming from the wrong neighborhood, or you won't be able to afford it, you know. But the vision in your heart is greater than where you are now, you know, or where you live at, or the family that you come from. So that vision that's in your heart, it could grow if in your mindset you say that, I'm going to go ye, I'm going to do, I'm going to be, you know, this what I envision to be. Okay. So great thinking precedes great achievement. Okay, so having a specific goal requires you to act, and it will be achievable. So if you have a specific goal in mind, like I gave you an example of wanting to be an astronaut or a doctor, if you move forward and strive for this thing, it is achievable. But it got to start in your heart. And you have to believe that you could do it. But always come back to the Bible and make sure that whatever your vision and your dreams is, that it lines up with the Word of God. It's so important that we not just doing this thing, though, that we're not doing it the world's way, but we are doing this thing God's way, and we are seeking Him first. It's very important. So I also had wrote down some other scriptures, but I want to say something about Habakkuk. Habakkuk had to do what he could to make the word of God known. Okay, so that meant screaming from the rooftops, or whatever the word says, so that people could hear it. He had to do whatever he needed to do to get that word out. Okay, he had to see the vision to make it known to others. He had to first see the vision for himself, because if you can't see it, how you gonna get others to see it? If you don't understand it, how can you get somebody else to understand and see the vision that God set before you, or the vision that's set before you? So he had to make the vision understandable to the people. Okay. Anybody have any questions? No? Okay. So I had other scriptures too. But I also wanted to say, when you are an engaged doer, that's a person that does what the word says, and go ye. Okay. It tells you to go. The Bible says go ye. And that's Mark 16:15-16. You want to read that, someone? Would someone like to read Mark 16:15-16? Okay. Let me get there myself. Okay. Mark 16:15 says, "And he said unto them, Go ye into all the world and preach the gospel to every creature. He that believeth and is baptized shall be saved, but he that believeth not shall be damned." But we have to go ye. We have to go ye and preach the gospel to all the creatures, to everyone, every person that we possibly could preach it to. Giving people the opportunity to change governments, change their government to the kingdom government, okay? To God's way, to God's rule, his reign. This is what we are to do. And that's an engaged doer, because you are doing what the word tells you to do. I also had Joel 2:28. Find it. Give me a minute, because it's funny. Really, I usually read without my, I had to take my glasses off to read. it's a little backwards, but I'm trying to work with reading with them on. Does somebody else want to read? Participate? Hello? Anybody there? Can y'all hear me?
I hear you.
Okay.
I was hoping one of the kids.
I hear you.
Okay.
Did somebody want to read, please? Joel, too? You got to find Joel.
I know.
Joel is in there somewhere.
It is. I'm looking for it myself, to be honest with you. And then in this Bible, I need a new one.
Who got their device out? Push Joel 2. Joel 2:28, right?
Yes. I'm getting ready to get it. So
I'm using all of my devices, so I can't use my device.
Okay, right. Well, that's fine.
That's all right. Help. Somebody come
I'm on getting down. Ready to I'm getting ready to I'll be there in 1 second. I like to read the King James Version.
That's why I put my stuff up. I'd be like, okay, I gotta put mine up because I ain't got time to look through this Bible. I got Joel 2 though. 2:28.
Yes.
Here you go. The Bible drills come in handy. And it shall come to pass afterward that I will pour out my spirit upon all flesh, and your sons and your daughters shall prophesy. Your old men shall dream dreams, your young men shall see visions.
Okay, right, yeah, right. So there go vision again. It said the old men shall dream dreams, but the young men shall see visions.
Yes.
And it said the daughters prophesy. Is that what it said?
Yeah, it said that all flesh, something about will prophesy. I'm gonna turn the tape. They're gonna
be... Oh, I'm sorry. You don't have to get back to it because I was gonna get to something else. But it speaks about vision even there. You know.
Yeah. Young men. So right. About the that's a species. Talking about men, that's men and women.
Right.
And when you read the Bible, you have to know the language. It's talking to men and women.
Yes.
To that you shall dream visions. I mean, you shall have visions.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah. That means in your dreams, too, you can have visions.
Yes. This is true.
Most of the time, we're so busy during the day, he had to speak to us while we're sleeping.
Yeah. This is true.
That's why Habakkuk said, write it down.
Right, and make it clear, make it plain, right. So that everybody can see it and they can understand it.
Right.
And then they can run with it.
Right.
You know, but if can you're I not making question? It wrong,
The question is, I'm talking to everybody. Can I ask everybody here on here a question? Do y'all have dreams? You can unmute.
Yes.
Do you write them down?
No.
Okay, that's what you got to do. When you have dreams, because the Lord may be giving you snap pictures of what you're supposed to be doing in the future. So write down the dream, even if it don't make sense to you. Put it in your journal. Date it. Y'all get what I'm saying? You understand?
Yes, I think.
Okay, and can y'all talk to us? Because we talking to y'all.
Yeah, you know? I don't hear anything from anybody.
Unmute, something in the chat, please.
Yes.
You know, that's how you.
Yeah, let us know you're there and you're getting something.
Right. We don't always wait to the end. Sometimes I like to engage while we.
Right, right, and it may be fresh.
Right.
You know, with somebody just got something. I'm going to. Jeremiah 29:11.
Oh yeah, that's one of my favorite ones. I almost know that by heart.
Go ahead.
I always say that with the kids, period, because they need to know the thoughts that God has towards them.
Right.
And God thinking about you. And so therefore he sends you download in your sleep or while you
work. Mm-hmm.
So verse 11 says, for I know the thoughts that I think. God is thinking towards you.
Yes.
So when God thinks something towards you, it's a download in your spirit, man. It, even whether you sleep or you woke. I don't mean teach you stuff. Sorry.
Yes. go ahead, because that's the verse. That's where I was going, 29:11.
Yeah, and then he says, for I know the thoughts I think towards you. So that means God's thinking towards you.
Yes.
So you even
thinking God, about us.
And God's thoughts is God breathed. That's the God's breath of life. When right. God thought something, he breathed something to you. And there you go. What do you say? And it says, the Lord thought of peace and not of evil to give you an expected end. God wants you to be successful.
Yes. Yes.
Follow the instructions. Write it down, what Habakkuk said.
Yes.
Dreams and visions. Write them down in the book and date
exactly.
them.
Yep, that's where I was going. This is true. This is so true. Let me see if I can. You shall see. Let me see. Well, that's where I was going with 11, but I'm just reading down further.
Okay.
And no, I was looking. I just wanted to see where it took me after that. Then 12 said, then shall ye call upon me, and ye shall go and pray unto me, and I will hearken unto you.
Yes.
It said, and ye shall seek me and find me when ye shall search for me with all your heart. Okay. And I will be found of you, saith the Lord, and I will turn away. You was going to say something?
No, I'm reading with you.
Yeah, and I will turn away your captivity, and I will gather you from all the nations and from all the places, whether I have driven you, saith the Lord, and I will bring you again into the place whence I caused you to be carried away captive. Okay. Mm-hmm. All right, but I really liked 11. That's what I was going through, Jeremiah 29 and 11. How about one more? How about 1 Chronicles 16 and 11? 1 Chronicles
16 and 11, right?
16 and 11.
You want me to read it?
Yes, please.
Seek the Lord and his strength. Seek his face continually. Will we read the next?
Let me see.
That's 1 Chronicles 16, verse 11, you said?
Yeah, seek the Lord and his strength and seek his face continually.
That's powerful.
Huh? Yeah,
that's so powerful because it goes with verse 12 and Jeremiah 29. 12, then shall you call upon me, and you shall go and pray unto me?
Yes.
And I will hearken unto you?
Yeah.
Proverbs 3, 5, and 6 says, trust in the Lord with all your heart.
Lean on your yes. Understanding. Yes.
Acknowledge
yes.
me in all your ways.
Yes.
And I shall direct your path. So it's like whatever the vision he gave you,
yeah,
writing it down. And God is already rooting for you because he done sent you a thought. That was the download he sent you. So you right. write, you obeying what his word is saying. And he says, and as you bring it to him in prayer, he said he will hearken unto you.
Yes.
Says, what do you want me to do with this? What does this mean, Lord? You talk to God like you would talk to your best friend.
Exactly.
And God will send you another thought, okay? He says, the thoughts I have towards you, he'll send you a thought towards you again. This is how you know it's coming from the spirit realm. It's a thought that God has sent to you in your spirit, which is your mind. That's not your right. brain, your mind.
Mm-hmm.
God sends you a thought.
Yeah.
This is what you're supposed to follow. That's how you call it walking in the spirit.
Yes.
When God sends you a thought. So the thoughts he has towards you are good and not
that's right and not evil. Exactly.
That's how you know the thought that came to you was God, because it's not of it's good but not of evil. So because
yeah,
you
get is good.
So you need to know what thought is this. The Jeremiah 29:11 just told you the thoughts towards you are of good and not of evil.
Amen. Yes. So I think that's all my little slides and information speaking about vision. Do anybody have any questions? What did you get from our lesson today? Anybody?
Come on, y'all, unmute. Let's go. Talk in the chat or something.
Nothing. Nothing about vision, dreams. Where you at, Bree?
I'm sorry, I'm right here.
Did you get any?
I was trying my best to listen, but I was in the middle of doing sort of stuff. I apologize. But I heard you talking about how God communicates with us through dreams and visions. Mm-hmm. So, and when Miss Odelia mentioned that we need to pay attention to our dreams, like even if it's a weird one. And I can actually attest to that as well, because I'm a dreamer. Sorry about that.
What'd you say? You froze. Dreams. Oh, there you go.
Because I said I'm a dreamer, because I have weird dreams, I don't like being a dreamer sometimes. Like if God is trying to tell me something through a dream, I'm not really into that, but I know that it's a gift that he gave me. It's something that I have to do, something I have to research and study on. So I will do, you know, I'll work with what he gives me. But when I dream, usually it's God telling me what's going on in the spirit, and he's never wrong. So I'm like, all right, God, I love that he can communicate with us. And it's funny how you were mentioning dreams and visions, because I was just talking to God yesterday, and we were talking about how, you know, people are, they do so much in a situation, and they keep like trying to reach out to God, pray to God and get him to move and get him to do stuff. But a lot of times the perfect moments when God can really get us to speak to us is when we're still. And he actually did a little something for me. He healed something in my body while I was asleep. So when I was up, I was like, you know, I'm praying to God, please heal me. And I'm, you know, I'm on my face, I'm on my knees. And, you know, it didn't really happen until after I woke up. And I was like, wow, God really healed me while I was asleep.
Wow.
But yeah, I really did like the message. God is definitely speaking in this time. He's always speaking. I heard somebody say, even when God is not, when it seems like God is not speaking, he's still speaking.
Oh, yes.
Like he speaks through the nature. He speaks through each other. He yes. absolutely speaks yes. through his word. The Holy yes. Spirit convicts us, and that's him speaking to us too. Like when you yes. get a funny feeling, or you go yes. around a place or a person and you're like, oh my gosh, and you feel so uncomfortable, that's the Holy Spirit convicting you.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? And her talking about visions and dreams, that's all a part of God communicating with us.
Yes.
You know, and like Miss O said, when you get a vision or a dream, Write it down, no matter how silly it is.
Write it down.
You know, if you envision yourself in some place or somewhere, or I want to travel, I want to be a doctor, like she said, whatever
right.
you can see yourself doing, as long as it's not hurting anybody and God can get the glory from it, write it down.
Yes.
And go to God about it. But it's a great exactly. word.
Thank yes. you.
Absolutely. And you also said something about looking the scriptures and make sure we're doing what God would call us. Philippians 4:13
mm-hmm.
says that we can do all things
through Christ.
So yes. it's not a specific thing, but whatever God has desired in your heart,
that's right.
what you have been designed to do,
exactly.
the gift that he has given to you. Remember, the gift he gave you is not just for you. The
right.
gift he gave you is for others, because God does
exactly.
not give us nothing for ourselves. It is to minister to others. It is something that the earth needs. So you'll mm-hmm. give whatever that gift is. It makes room for you, even though you're going to be blessing other people.
Mm-hmm.
So we got to remember Philippians 4:13 tells, that's a word for you, that whatever your dream is, that's what God, you know, God said you could do all things through Christ.
That's right. Who strengthens you. Yes, right. You can. This is true. I'm going to read it. You said Philippians 4 and 13. Yep, that's what it says. I could do all things through Christ, which strengthens me. Let me see how the Amplified word it. I'm going to read it from the Amplified, okay? Okay. It says, I have strength for all things in Christ who empowers me. I am ready for anything and equal to anything through him who infuses inner strength into me. I am self-sufficient in Christ's sufficiency.
Hmm. Amen. Amen. Can I piggyback on what she just said?
Mm-hmm. Sure.
About earlier when you mentioned checking the word, mm-hmm. I absolutely agree with that, because the Holy Spirit always backs up his own word, and everything that goes on in this earth, in this world, you can absolutely find it in the scripture. Yeah. Sometimes it's not always specific to a certain thing, but there's definitely a category that it's under. The Bible talks about everything that can happen under the sun. And when you get into prayer and God starts revealing things to you and really speaking to you, and you write it down and you're kind of like, what in the world are you saying, Lord? Or, you know, maybe the Lord will give you an encouraging word or something that's inspirational. Make sure you go back into the scripture and search it out.
Mm-hmm.
Because, you know, while we're in this process of trying to discern whose voice we're listening to, I'm not saying that we want to check God, but just make sure we're checking ourselves through his word. Because there's a lot of times where we can be speaking his word and don't even know it. But that's the Holy Spirit speaking through us.
Through us, yeah.
One time I was praying for somebody, and I was saying something. I didn't even know what I was saying, really. But all I know is I felt the Spirit of God on me while I was praying for someone. And they said, wow, that, you know, what you were saying was so true. And I really felt the Spirit. And afterwards, the person was like, what did you say? And I couldn't even remember what I said, because it really wasn't my words. It was God's words. Mm. Do you know, later on, I heard that scripture and I was like, what? I said, Lord, you done used me. I was like, okay, Jesus. So that is amazing thing to be used by God. But make sure whenever you guys get really a vision or a dream, research that thing in the scripture, man. I promise you, it's there in some way, shape, or form.
It is.
The Holy Spirit always backs up his word, always.
Exactly. And it's good to have a relationship with the Father, you know.
Exactly.
This is what he, you know, because that relationship is just so important for our lives, you know. So leading and guiding us, that's what the Holy Spirit does. Lead and guide us into all truth and show us things to come. You know, but we have to have the relationship to be able to be led by the Spirit of God. Because if you don't have a relationship, you don't know who's speaking to you, is like you just said. You know?
Exactly. Like for those who only talk to God on Sundays, like how can you really expect God to hear your prayer, answer your prayer on a Wednesday if you're only going to talk to him on a Sunday?
Or talk to him when you're having a problem or when something is going on.
Exactly.
You're afraid. You know, we should have a relationship with God, period. Daily.
Yeah.
In our life.
And God wants to speak to us. He wants to pour into us. He wants to help us. He wants to lead us. We have to give to him as well. It's a two-way street. We want him to talk to us. We got to talk to him.
Exactly.
We want him to guide us. We have to be teachable and be willing to be led by him. Surrender to him.
And we had to trust him. We have to trust and have faith.
Well, I feel like a lot of people. Mm-hmm. Sorry, go ahead.
No, you go ahead.
I feel like a lot of people get tripped up because they so often go off their own understanding. They're like, okay, I'm gonna try God out and, you know, see what he's all about. And then when God tells them to do something that they think is completely ridiculous, they forfeit. And they're like, nah, this church thing ain't for me. But you have to go off of God's understanding. You have to want to understand what God is trying to show you, what he's trying to tell you. And it is there. What was that? Something about mysteries and we got to search it out. I just had my finger on it earlier. Hold on. Proverbs 25:2, King James Version. It is the it is the glory of God to conceal a thing, but the honor of kings is to search out a matter. So we gotta search the Lord for these things. Search through his scripture. See what he's telling us. Like, don't just sit on it.
Don't just read it. But you gotta search it out and study it out. You do. Don't just read it.
That's Proverbs 25, verse 2.
Pray on it. Meditate on it.
Yeah, and that's 20, Joshua 1:8. That's the meditating stuff.
Yeah, I just read it.
Okay. Did you let other people in?
I didn't see where.
Because Jillian said let us in. I don't know how long.
I'm sorry. Where do I let them in at?
You don't see the little blue thing up there? Admit.
No, it's not on here at all. Sorry.
Did you go in participation?
That's what it
usually is. Pops up on the top.
Yeah, she probably didn't see it when it first happened. Okay, I know it's, you know, we concentrating here.
Yeah.
You know.
And you know, sometimes you got to get more and more into technology. Mm-hmm. And then don't be wanting to mess with it and have it all jammed all up.
Look, I'm serious. Pastor Anthony says he like your PowerPoints.
Oh, thank you.
Well, I'm going to read what he got
I'm
up
there. I'm glad he has it on Zoom and on Facebook.
Oh, here comes Deb, too. Debbie's on it. And then Pastor Anthony said, he says, people look at me like I'm just a serious, no-nonsense person, which I am, but those that really know me see the comedian, goopy side of me. That's when you was talking about what we thought we seeing and how we see people.
Uh-huh.
And then he had wrote that on there. My Facebook Live just popped in. I was looking for it all this time. It just popped in. So I couldn't see it. So sorry for those who's watching Facebook and you put something down. A lot of time I won't see it till after it. But right. I'm glad I see it now.
Can y'all hear me?
Yes.
We hear you.
Hello.
Hey, Miss Deborah.
I've been on here, but I was waiting. Okay. I'm in now.
Yes.
You have anything?
Good to see you, Deb. Good to see you.
You got too. Anything you want to add?
Ed, I don't even know. I didn't hear the lesson. I just got in.
Oh, you're just getting in.
I'm just getting in. I just heard all of a sudden talking. I just left the screen up. It was saying waiting.
Oh, no.
Yeah.
Jillian was on too.
Anthony. Yeah.
My apology.
Jillian was trying to get in.
My apology to you guys. I didn't go to the participants because I didn't see the blue button or whatever until I went to participant. So now I know, but I apologize. And we were talking about vision. That's what we were speaking about.
I get all y'all on here now. Just hit participant.
No. Would you say how do you?
You got to open up with it.
Share.
No.
Go up the top of your picture. Go up the top of your picture. You'll see some dots up there. Go up the top of your picture, and then that should open it up for everybody. Because that.
I ain't gonna mess with it because I probably lose y'all again. Okay. I just see you.
Do you see the button at the top that says view?
Let me get my
glasses. In the corner. And the corner is view, so that that you open that up, and then you'll be able to see everybody. All right, so I don't see no more stuff up here on Facebook Live. But my Facebook Live just popped up. I'm like, I've been looking for it all the time.
Wow.
And they were on Facebook Live, and that's how I know Jillian said, let me in, let us in.
Oh.
Yeah.
Oh.
Mm-hmm. And she wrote down, like, that's good, sis. Think big.
I was saying, oh my God, they must be having difficulty. That's what I said. I'm going to just leave it up.
Okay.
So from then on, what I'll do is, you know, I'll just go into participants and check.
Yeah, we learning as we go, because it usually has the blue little thing come up, but it probably disappear if you're not watching.
Right. All I see the whole bar, but I don't see anything about anybody trying to get in. At one point, I did see something before.
What's that?
I was saying somebody was asking to come in, and I was able to hit that button, but not this time.
Yeah, that's because you probably saw it when they put it up there.
Okay.
Pastor Anthony said, practice makes perfect technology.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
I'm telling you, and the more, because I'm noticing the more we do this, the more I get a little more relaxed with it. Whereas in the beginning, it was like really nervous to actually speak. You scared you. You know, it's not going to come across or something going, you know, you got to like, no, I'm not going to do that. Let the Holy Spirit minister and teach. And that's what I'm going to do. And I'm going to be fine and I'm going to relax.
Right. Absolutely. You know? And that's how all of us, you know, we all have to go through this process.
That's exactly what it is. A process.
Yeah. Like each one of y'all, when Vet talk, you pop up. And then when Old talk, she pops up.
Okay.
That never happened before. I don't know what's going on.
Oh, yeah, because I see it on Facebook is doing the same thing.
What is it doing?
Oh, Jennifer is on. Jennifer Rose on Facebook. Hey, Jennifer.
Hello, Jennifer.
She's on Facebook Live. Amen. She said, relax. She said, relax.
Oh, no, I'm fine. I've been telling myself I'm going to relax. I'm not going to be all excited and nervous, you know, because when you do that, it seems like you can't think right. Things ain't, you know, don't go the way you kind of plan it. But I said, just let the Holy Spirit go ahead and teach. And
That's right.
It ain't about me.
Right. Teach from the overflow.
That's right. It ain't about me. When you make it about you, that's when you kind of get all nervous and nope, it ain't about me. Let's get this word in.
Right. Nevaeh. Nevaeh, can you hear me, Nevaeh? Nevaeh, what you get today? Did you take notes?
I didn't bring any because I'm back.
All right. Anybody else got something? We heard Bree, what she got. Is anybody still on here? Landis, you get anything? Got anything in the chat? Three Musketeers, y'all get anything? If you can't speak on the speakers, use the chat, please. And then we can read what you got. This way we all be impacted with what you got. Go ahead. Wait. I'm waiting. Nah, not today.
Everybody likes today.
I don't see nothing in the chat neither. Nothing.
Okay. All right.
All right, well, we in.
Okay.
Thank you for being here, Jennifer. Good morning, my sister. She said hello. Tell it like it is. And Anthony Young, Pastor Anthony Young said, that's right, Evette. I forget what he said that about, but he said, that's right, Evette. Uh-oh, wait a minute. Somebody wrote something. Three Musketeers. That's Alaya, Anaya, and Isaiah. We just got on the Zoom, so we don't have anything. Okay.
Oh, I apologize. for not seeing that button, but now I know to go to participants and I could let everybody in.
Right. All right, it's 11 o'clock anyway, so thank y'all all for being here. Oh, wait a minute, Landis wrote something. Landis wrote, write the vision and make it plain.
Yes.
Come on, Landis. You preaching yes. now. You preaching, bro.
Write the vision and make it plain.
That's right. Y'all get those, y'all get those visions and them dreams. Write them down and date them. God's gonna put a puzzle together for you and watch and see what manifests from it.
That's true. That's good. That's good.
All right, y'all. Is that it? That's it. All right. Anybody want to end in prayer?
I will.
Go ahead, Brie.
Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for this beautiful day, Lord God. We thank you for waking us all up today, Father God. We thank you for your presence, Lord, that is always with us, Lord. Your word says you are omnipresent. You are everywhere at all times, Father God. Lord, we thank you for your keeping power, your staying power, Lord God. Thank you for keeping us, Father God. Thank you for keeping us all safe, Father God. Thank you for having us as the apple of your eye, Father God. Yes. Thank you, Lord, for your divine protection, for your the visions that you give us, Father God. Thank you for making a way for us, Lord God, for the doors that you open, for the doors that you're going to open for us, Father God. We thank you for what you are doing and what you are going to do in each in our lives, Father God. I thank you for the blessings that you put on everybody's lives who are represented here, Father. I just pray that you continue to bless them, continue to open their spiritual eyes and ears to you only, Father God. Help us to continue to understand your word, consume your word, digest your word in our spirits, Father God. Lord, I pray that you can bless the your woman servant on today who brought forth the word, Lord Amen. God. Continue to keep her household, Lord God, in perfect peace. In Jesus' name. But I just pray that you allow us to have a good day, Lord God. Speak to our day and tell it to be kind in Jesus' name. Lord, we love you. Lord, we trust you. And we look forward to taking you with us throughout the rest of our day, God. In Jesus' name, amen.
In Jesus' name, amen.
So be it. So be it. It. So be it. Mm. Jesus. Jesus. So y'all can't see
like
me
that
dancing.
Energy. I like that energy, Bree. God bless
all
everybody.
You guys. Love y'all.
Have a blessed day. Love you too.